the mirror of my mind. Time after time I see reflections of you and me, reflections of the way life used to be, reflections of tears that I'm crying, reflects the hurt I can't control. Cause although you're gone, I keep holding on to the happy time, ooh, and you were mine. As I peer through the window of lost time, looking over my yesterday and all the lost from the hurt that you have caused. Everywhere I turn, seems like everything I see reflects the love that used to be.
Okay.
I graduated in 76.
Okay.
Went into the Navy in 76, the day after I graduated.
Okay, walk with me.
Okay.
Because we're going to go up to the doorstep.
Now, prior to me graduating, I used to be one of the head photographers for Southeastern High School.
Really?
Yes. I also, along with Mr. Crawford, started the college club for Southeastern High School. At that time, Miss Margaret Montgomery was the principal at that time. Okay.
What color was she? I'm sorry.
She was African American.
And what year was this?
1976.
Okay.
And Mr. Jefferson was the, superintendent.
Okay.
At the time. I also photographed him at the time. It's all in the yearbook of 1976.
Okay.
Almost every picture in the yearbook I did.
Now tell me something about that era. We were mentioning something about the similarities of the Jim Crow era. Was that, changed somewhat during that time? Was it better, for worse, or the same, or what?
Well, 1976, right. It was still the same as far as prejudice was concerned, as far as me being in the United States Navy.
Okay.
Yes, it was very prejudiced. Right. It was so prejudiced, I almost lost my life 3 times due to my co-workers' ownership.
What? Co-workers' ownership, if you can enlighten me a little bit more.
My Navy comrades on the ship, which consisted of about 45 whites and two or three African Americans and one Indian.
Wow.
Yeah, it was highly prejudiced.
So during your education years from, let's say, you said you came out in 76, so you had to start what, 72. Tell me about that time. Was it more black teachers then, more black students? What was it?
It was mixed, black and white.
Okay, you had half Caucasian teachers, half black teachers?
Black teachers, white teachers, and I guess you would call Mr. Borelli a Spaniard.
Okay. Yeah. Wow. And then what was the curriculums? What kind of classes that you took up during your tenure?
Don't ask me that one.
Were you a sports guy? Did you have swimming? What did you have?
Well, my main issue at the time was the the DECA program.
Okay.
Which was marketing and business management. I always wanted to pursue management, and which I did.
Oh wow. And then what was your favorite course and your least favorite course?
All of them was my favorite.
Right?
I did good in all of them.
And what kind of grades did you get?
Oh, we go.
But they were your favorite, right?
Yes, they were.
Did you have a favorite mentor or teacher that just took, a grip of your life and just made a huge, significant, difference?
I had two teachers and a principal.
What was their name?
Christopher. Let's see, what was his name? Crawford.
Okay.
Chris Crawford. And let's see. Miss Davis.
Okay, and Mr. Crawford taught, or Mrs. Crawford, or Mr. Crawford taught what class? Do you remember?
Mr. Crawford taught history.
Okay, and Miss Davis taught?
Miss Davis taught, I think it's English.
English?
Yes.
Now, during that time, were you popular in school, or it seemed like you was popular with the ladies, but that's another day and another story. But were you the quiet type, or what? You just wanted to get it over and done with? Did you love your school years, or what?
No, I wasn't the quiet type. In fact, I was anything but.
Okay, we gonna leave that one alone. Okay, were you, during this time you said you attended this school for all 4 years, is that correct?
Yes.
Now, were you generally living in this neighborhood at the time, and if so, where?
Yes, I used to live on St. Jean between Charlevoix and Goffey. In fact.
And come all the way over here to school?
Yeah, just a block, 2 blocks.
2 blocks, okay.
I can cut through somebody's backyard and be right here.
All right.
And not only that, but before I even got here, I used to be the paper boy for Southeastern and folks.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah.
So did you keep your class of 76 yearbook?
I'm finna get another one.
Okay, you about to get another one? Yeah. Okay, that sounds like a plan.
Matter of fact, I just left here about a month ago, and I got the information I need to go and try to locate one.
Oh, wow. Okay, yeah, that's a start, memories,
All the time.
But, I wanted to ask you, too, before we end this valuable testimony of yours. How old were you during the 67 riots?
Oh,
and can you remember?
1967 riots? You want to know how old I am, huh?
Because here, your school has history with the 67 riots. Because I forget the platoon that actually stationed out here and slept in your yards and everything else during the 67. They actually used your facilities, your school facilities, for that rebellion. For their soldiers to get, you could Google it, so their soldiers can get arrest during the 67 riot.
Oh.
Correct. They camped out here. They had tents and everything.
Okay, for the 67 riots, prior to Martin Luther King walking down Mack Avenue, I used to live on Baldwin and Mack. In fact, Martin Luther King walked straight down at Mack Avenue.
Really? Do you recall which year?
Before the riots.
Before the riots, okay.
When he did that, the first I Had a Dream speech was done at that time.
So, do you think it was 67 or 66?
It was actually maybe about 65 when
65,
came
because
down.
68 he got assassinated.
I know that.
Yeah.
So that's part of the cause of the riot. And at that time, like I said, I was about 11.
And what do you recall? You had to recall something during that era. Did you grasp fully what was going on?
Of course, I remember the control the tanks
And you guys had a curfew, correct? Oh wow, did it scare you? What kind of mood were you in? Confused?
As a child, you don't quite understand everything that's going on, but I did get the concept of what was happening.
Right, and probably didn't find out till years later that we was actually under martial law.
No, I knew then we was at martial law.
Oh wow.
Yeah, my family made me a wrestler.
And how serious it was for blacks, correct?
Yes.
Oh wow.
All the looting, the rioting, all of that, yes.
So, summing all this up, compare back then to now, has anything changed for the better, for the worse? Is it the same? Would you do it all over again? What would you do, the same or different or what?
That's for another story.
Another story?
Yes.
Okay. Thanks. But other than that, you don't have no regrets this far?
I regret the losses that we suffered during that time. I really regret that. Mm-hmm.
Because we destroyed our own communities.
Not just that.
I won't say we had help. I found out later it just wasn't, blacks that helped us. It was all races that participated. But the big story was just our faces on there, that we basically destroyed our own Black Wall Street.
Okay, we might have did that, but they did that long before we did.
Okay, okay.
Go back to when they did Oklahoma. Put Oklahoma. And look at the history that we had there. Mm-hmm. Where we had our own airplanes. We had our own markets. We had our own banks. Mm-hmm. What happened then? Mm-hmm. They took that. Mm-hmm. They destroyed that. And they destroyed a part of us at the same time.
Now,
I don't hold no ill feels for them, but at the same time, I will not never forget.
Oh, of course not. Of course not, sir. Last but not least, I see your veteran, your Navy veteran hat on. What was your tincture and what was your experience like? I mean, I want to hear the good. I already heard the negative.
Well, I'm going to tell you this. I was...
You said you graduated in 76 and got...
I was... The day after I graduated in 1976, the next day, I was recruited into the United States Navy. When I went into the Navy, I was stationed on a ship called the USS Gallant MSO 489, where we deactivate floating mines out of the Pacific Ocean.
Oh, wow.
That was my job.
Oh, wow. And was it some good times, not also bad times?
Mostly it was all about, about me being on the ship with just three African Americans. And all the rest, 45 Europeans. Mm-hmm. It was rough. Matter of fact, it was very difficult.
Right.
But I got out with honorable discharge.
Okay. And what year was that? You said 2 years later or three years?
Yeah, it was a couple years later. I got out with honorable discharge. I was injured in the Navy, and from there, I've been fighting ever since to win my disability compensation, which I just started to get.
Okay, wow.
From the United States Navy.
Right, for being persistent.
Almost 40 years.
40 years?
Almost 40 years in the making.
Oh my.
It's all new.
Yeah, it's all brand new. Plus, they got Chrysler, somebody working with them.
Now, they said they're not working with them no more.
But they were.
Yeah, because that's when they built the new part on
right,
to the back.
Right.
And now, this guy named Ricky over there barbecuing, he was telling me they had closed the third floor off. They closed Folks down because they used to have 9th, 10th, and 11th at Folks.
What? And when then, was this?
A couple years ago. See, what they did was...
Is this next building over here Folks?
Yeah, that was Folks. That was the middle school.
Yeah,
but
right.
What they used to do was have the Southeastern 12th graders. And they had 9th, 10th, and 11th at Folks, but it was still all together Southeast.
Oh, okay. And that's because they went out of the...
I think when Chrysler had all
that stuff. When the Chrysler company
came
in.
They had all that money.
Yeah, they had devoted it to Southeast.
Okay. And it was much bigger then.
Yeah.
So it was legally then, was supposed to be the largest high school and stuff.
Kansas. Did you attend there too, Folks?
I went to Folks for middle school.
Okay.
And then... came over here.
I went to Folks and Southeast. I did my 2 years over there and I came straight over
here. Because I went to Remus Robinson for seventh grade, went there for eighth grade, and here for high school.
I started Little Bridge. Used to be a safety patrolman at Little Bridge. Came over here, used to be a paper boy for a post dance office.
Do you remember Mr. Scott?
Yeah.
You know they had his funeral here.
What? Mr. Scott?
Scott.
Was he white or black?
He's black.
I wonder if I'm related to him. My last name is Scott.
He's a gym teacher.
He was a gym teacher. They had a cremated. And they had a funeral. His funeral.
What was his name?
Scott.
Mr. Scott.
And he taught what?
He taught gym.
Gym.
Scott and Lawson.
And he died when?
It's been a couple years ago.
Oh, wow.
I didn't know that.
Yeah. Okay. And he passed it. His wife came, you know, got in contact with as many people as she could. And
yeah,
they had
he was a hell of a gym
Yes. Oh, yeah. It broke my heart. But I came up here. I made sure I came up here and stayed. Because they had got the times crossed and everything. But they had him a memorial in the gym.
Oh, my God.
And a whole, like,
In fact, you can put this in your
documentary.
Yeah, Mr. Scott and Mr. Lawson helped instrument me getting my disability from the VA because I had to come back here almost 30 years later to get there to write a document.
I know you remember Mr. Sims.
Yes, Sims.
I went to his family.
Mr. Sims, now what did football he teach?
Yeah. Football coach.
Football coach.
Oh, my God.
Yeah,
Mr. Lawson lives in, I think, down south.
Oh, is he?
But he's still living.
Yeah, anyway, I had to come here for them to write me a letter stating that it wasn't, you know, I had no injuries or nothing prior to going into service. Yeah.
Is your name on that memorial or that was way before your time?
Those are, I think,
okay. Wow. Well, I certainly thank you, sir, for your precious time and valuable, precious memories of this legacy, celebrating your 100th year here at Southeastern, Michigan, on Fairview, here in Detroit, Michigan.
You're very welcome.
Wow.